and we are inside Kilbourne Hall, Kodak Hall, Eastman Theater. You, no matter how you say it, it's Eastman Theater with Michael Vidala. Michael, thanks so much for joining us.
Very glad to be here. Thank you, Derek.
And you've got a show. Actually, you have two shows tonight. What times?
Our first set will be a little bit of trio, a little bit of five-piece funk, and that will start at 7 p.m. and go until 8. Our second set will be a larger group with horns and percussionists and an extra keyboard player, a third keyboard player even, and that will go from 9 until 10.
Speaking with Michael Vidala here on Jazz 90.1. Michael, we have to give you a lot of credit because Snarky Puppy just played Saturday night, and it was you who actually got them on the radio here in Rochester because you'd send me Facebook blasts of clips, YouTube clips, that you got to check these guys out, you got to check these guys out, and you got to play them. And they're like, we don't have any music from them. And then all of a sudden, a couple phone calls, we got music, and we're playing them, and well, you saw the results. So again, thank you so much. Personally, we want to thank you for getting the ball rolling on that.
Well, I'd just like to thank Snarky Puppy for being so inspiring and just making really great music, something that we're also trying to do here in Rochester. And they've really hit it on a global scale, which is great for them.
And speaking of Snarky Puppy, how much have they influenced what you're doing in terms of composing, arranging, and even the concept of marketing with using a CD and DVD?
Yeah, I mean, those guys really kind of paved the way, I think, for a lot of musicians, especially musicians who specialize in playing their music live and together, whereas a lot of music that is maybe not jazz-oriented wouldn't so much be benefiting from that same market.
That said, Michael, follow-up question on that, because so many jazz musicians and artists are so reluctant to embrace technology. They're so reluctant to use the tools they have at their disposal, whether it be YouTube or Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, or just getting their fans involved. And you guys have really been doing that in the Rochester area. Why is that so important for bands, especially jazz and jazz-oriented bands, to take use advantage of the stuff that they have, like social media?
Well, even, you know, just with anything that's always changing, jazz is too. We always have new influences and new people. You know, there's Robert Glasper, there's Snarky Puppy, Gerald Clayton. You know, that's not exactly the Miles and John Coltrane generation. Exactly. It's 2014 now. We have so much more to be inspired by, and we shouldn't be limiting ourselves just to the old stuff, even though we do pay respect to it and we understand the history and the importance of that. Just taking on new things and using all we have at our disposal is really important to keep this kind of music alive.
Michael, what got you playing?
Well, I would have to chalk that one up to my dad. He's always had instruments around at the house and always encouraged us to try new things, try different instruments, pushed us to be the best we could be. And so, yeah, my whole family is really a musical family, and my dad definitely inspired me and introduced me to music, like a lot of Motown stuff that first got me angled towards the jazz genre.
Two shows tonight. Michael Vidala, we can't be more prouder of you, man. You're bringing jazz to Rochester, you're, as well as doing the things you're doing in terms of getting the word out, in terms of having people come out and see live shows, just not your shows, but live shows in general that really reflect what's happening in the jazz world today.
Thank you, and I'd like to put out a huge thanks to 90.1. I mean, you guys have been right there behind us, having our backs and helping us out with some really great opportunities, even like this one. And you guys, not just us, but all artists in this area and even some out-of-town artists, you guys have really helped out. So we all really appreciate that.
So for more information on what you're doing, where can we go?
You can go to our Facebook at facebook.com/Michael Vidala Trio. That's our old band name. Or you can follow us on Twitter at Mike Vidala Tribe, and that's our new band name. Still MVT, however.
Yeah, either way. It's MVT.
You know it.
All right, Michael. Thanks so much.